this video, we're going to talk about OCF fault on ATV31 and ATV312 drives. OCF means overcurrent fault. There are a few things we need to check in order to remedy this fault. First, we need to check motor data. Make sure all your motor parameters, such as standard motor frequency, voltage, current, speed, and cosine are set per the motor nameplate. Also, you need to check UFT, which is motor control parameter. Make sure it's set per application. For example, if it is fan application, make sure it's set for variable torque. If it is a constant torque application, you can either select constant torque or SVC. Another thing to check is the ITH, which is motor thermal current. Motor thermal current must again match the motor FLA, so make sure that is set correctly. Also, under errors detection, you can check the FLR, catch on the fly, and you can enable it if it's not already enabled. If it's set to no, go ahead and set it to yes. The motor current being pulled by the motor is also important to check. If you have SoMove connected, you can check the LCR motor current, see how much current the motor is pulling. Make sure it does not exceed the drive rating or the motor rating. This LCR parameter is also available through the keypad as well. Must make sure that the motor rotation is correct. The rotation is wrong, then go ahead and correct the rotation by switching any of the two leads on the output of the VFD. The last thing is to make sure to look at the fault itself and confirm if it is OCF, O.CF, or OC.F. So if it is OCF, then we already talked about the things to check. If it is O.CF, it could be a phase short circuit on the motor or the cables. It could be a ground short, or OC.F is also another short on the motor or the cable. So depending upon which particular OCF it is, you need to react accordingly. And that should conclude our OCF fault check.